Alrighty, fast forward because I'm running a lot. We are in No Town. I'm gonna talk to the elven lady, Nissa.
Oh, greetings, Messer. My mistress is away seeing to a customer, but she will be back shortly. Is there anything I can do to help you?
You could tell me about your husband, Huon. That would be helpful.
When the Templars came, I told them the truth. I hadn't seen Huon in 10 years. But after they left, he came to me. He wanted me to hide him. I used to dream of him returning, but not like this. He's changed, and I don't know him anymore. I sent him away.
Oh, well.
Good riddance. You don't need to be tied down to some man.
If he had been himself, I would have taken him back gladly. But Huon said he would return to take me away from this forever. I don't know what he means, and I am afraid of him, Messer.
I hate being smartass in times that are serious, but sticking with the character.
Don't worry. He probably means to carry you off into the moonlight on the back of a horse.
I think whatever he is planning is much more sinister. Huon said he would come to the alienage soon, at nightfall. Are you going to arrest him? I think he needs help. Maybe the circle will be able to heal whatever troubles him.
Well, I know just the place to do a quick zoom in, zoom out. Alright, it's nighttime and I see an arrow. Oh! What the hell?
Huon.
He doesn't look very good, does he? Oh boy.
Hush, love. Don't be afraid. Your blood will bring new life to our people.
Oh boy.
So beautiful.
Someday I'd like to go 1 week without meeting an insane mage. Just 1 week.
I'm a visionary. I've seen our destiny. I know what fate holds for the elves. The humans keep us down because they're afraid of the magic within us. Look at the magic Nissa held inside her. She was just afraid to use it.
What is it with elves and blood magic?
Time to die. I mean, kill something. Oh, him. You know, whoops. Shit. He has this aura that is just downright nasty. And he was just about to do it, and now I'm stuck in it. Shoot. Not good. Although it might not be too much of an issue since I am playing this on freaking kindergarten mode, but still. That aura is a nasty piece of work. Oh yeah, look at that. Down in like 4 hits. I'm a badass. Suck on a fireball. Anders, language. Alright. Oh man, we didn't get turn time. Damn. But crazy posse's dead. No big deal. Or, well. Ooh, my champion boots! Finally! After all this time. Ooh. The scarf. Alright, let's put my boots on. Well, shoot. I don't know if that'll look good with my outfit. Because it's gonna match. Ah, they look alright. But see, these boots are better. Aren't they? Oh, they're not. Okay, that works for me. And my gauntlets of awesomeness. Yeah. What is this? But that looks weird. I guess I can wear that for a while. Yeah, whatever. That works. Don't really like plate mail too much, but... Oh, I can use Miro's house, but sometimes I'll find an outfit I can tolerate. Alright. Now we have a few more things to do, or I think that's it. Justice, locate Evelyn in Darktown. Alright, we can go to Darktown really quick. That's what we'll do now. Hey, kids, what's up? Wow, that shoulder pad is humongous.
We got nothing here you'd want. Get back to Hightown and leave us alone.
You're a little young for a blood mage. And I thought Evelina was a girl's name.
I'm not Evelina, I'm Walter. Evelina was our friend. She was our mother. Evelina found us when the Darkspawn came, when our parents died. She made sure we got to Kirkwall safely.
I miss her.
But when she went to join the circle here, they called her apostate. For leaving the tower and for Elden. They locked her up.
Well, crap.
What was she expecting? Welcome. Here's a bag of gold for your urchin.
You think we deserve to live like this? Evelina just wanted to give us the lives we would have had at home. But when she came back to us, the Templars followed her.
The Templars made Evelina angry. They made her change. It wasn't her fault. When it was over, she was ashamed. She ran into the tunnels and hid.
Shut up, Cricket. Don't tell them that.
Geez.
Evelina's in the sewer tunnels.
You can't go there. She'll know we told you and she'll be angry at us.
Angry? I didn't like when she got angry. We have to hide. Cricket!
What's funny about those two boys is the older one sounds like what the younger one should sound like, and the younger one sounds like what the older one should sound like. Oh, comedy. But I think that is all the time we have for this episode, so I'm going to have to pause it here, and we will hunt down the crazy lady and the little boys in the next episode. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this wonderful marathon. It was fun and exciting and got a lot done and still more to come. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed it and I will see you on the next one. Bye!